Jesus Christ, I barely recognise you. Come on, Hoppy.
Your mum been putting steroids in your Weet-Bix.
So what are you now, 15?
16.
16. I'd say I was like you at your age. It was a right tear away. Me and your old man got up to all sorts of nonsense back in the day. That's quite a shiner you got there. Have a bloke in a coma, is it? Look, you just got to ignore these twats, you know? Just keep your head down. Try and get a handle on that temper of yours. You'll grow out of it.
And any other useless words of wisdom?
Look, your mum's going through a bit of a tough time at the moment. She needs you to be the man of the family.
Mum needed you 5 years ago. I mean, when was the last time we even saw you? A few.
Look, I just thought this would be a good opportunity.
I'm here because the letter said I had to be.
What do you want to go back to that shit hell for? Alex.
Sign it or don't.
Okay. Bungle. This is my nephew, Alex. He's with us today on the paddle.
All right, mate.
You all right, Al?
Fucked off, Malky.
Of course.
He's fucked off.
Well, there's still no new bats. The secondary compound's a past sell-by, and the comms are dicking around again. So take your fucking pick.
Take your pick, bruv.
Take it easy, man. We'll get it all sorted, I promise you.
Wait, I don't think Crew 9 have to deal with this.
What is this place?
They make those things. And these.
It's my birthday. Would you like something?
Creepy. I've
got to pop off, boss, to the docks.
Get your ass back here as soon as possible, please.
All right, sweet. Who's,
Alex. Paddle.
Paddle?
This is Alex.
In the road?
Yeah.
Is that even safe?
It's not where you got to watch out for, bruv.
Hey, lads.
Bye, right, Bungo.
Let's take a look at this bastard, shall we?
Tell me, why are we always cleaning up other people?
Our tax contribution hard at work.
Please don't get rolled up, babe.
What a bloody joke! Oh, finally woken up, have we? Jesus Christ. Why do you never seem to be doing anything?
We're on a break.
Oh, I saw that girl again last night.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, took her out, really treated her. Pushed the boat out.
Carvery?
Yeah, 30 quid all in. It was Carvery. Delicious.
He loves his Carvery.
You got any tunes on this thing?
Crew 9 to Purley. Situation active. Outbreak needs to be contained immediately.
You hungry, Al?
Yeah?
There's a burger van around the corner. 3 bacon sandwiches and 3 teas.
Be a good lad.
Some kid out. They were going to stick him back in that place. I don't want him here any more than you do.
Why?
He needed some kind of work placement.
Well, I'm just saying this is not a good idea.
Look, he's my brother's kid, Malcolm. He'll be up top. It'll be fine.
Shit. That's not good.
Says there's something still moving down there.
Going down there, then?
Yeah. Get your shit together.
All right, Al, listen, we've got to go down below and sort something out.
Where'd you get those goggles?
I've got some.
I need an upgrade.
Ooh. What's down there?
Stay up here, keep an eye out. Nobody comes down, including you. Got it?
Hello, Control. You there? Fuck's sake. Control, I'm in trouble there. Can you read me? Hello, Control. Be at full contact. We can really dump some backup. Control. We can really dump some backup. Are you picking this up? Control. Malcolm!
Brian?
Malky?
What?
It's me, T-Bars!
What the fuck?
You come to play!
Vroom.
What?
Vroom.
My friends are learning with you!
Malky! What? Malky, you're right. What was that?
Take these.
What?
Your uncle! Brian! Help him!
Interdimensional entity tracking system now online.
Fuck.
Proximity alert. Proximity alert. Inanimate form. Standing by. Insufficient battery. System shutting down. Goodbye.
Fuck. Uncle Brian.
Ow. Shh. There's something in here.
But Malcolm.
Shh. Just stay here. Nice goggles.
Fuck.
Ingenious little bastard. Was attempting to pull it to the body. Look at that. Huh.
What is it?
It's interdimensional something or other. We call them fucktards. Cheers, Al. You just saved my ass. Just like your dad did on numerous occasions.
Dad did this?
Yeah.
Where's it from?
Dunno. All I know is they come through and we block them up.
They come through?
Yeah. It's quite nice, this one.
No fucking way.
It's all peaceful.
But what's the through there?
Fuck knows, mate. Not our department. Charm.
Right, let's block this bastard up.
Go upstairs and get the gear. Stick the kettle on while you're up there. These are shit, by the way. Bet crew and I wouldn't have to deal with this. That's pretty good.
Don't worry, I won't show anyone.
No, they'll believe you anyway.
Unbelievable. You're still not doing anything. What do you actually do?
Well, you see, the thing is,
we're on a break.
You're a bit quiet, Marko. You all right?
Yeah, of course.
Enchanté.
Enchanté.
Ça dérange si on se tutoie ?
Non, je préfère.
Ok, viens avec moi. Tu vas me dire que c'est le travail le plus ennuyeux sur Terre et t'auras raison. J'aimerais que tu surveilles mon garage le temps que je termine un projet. En ce moment, il me sert d'atelier, je travaille plutôt la nuit. Donc voilà ce que je te propose. Tu fais une ronde de 2 heures et puis tu viens ici te reposer, il fait plus chaud.
Attends, Francis ? C'est pas un peu trop de précautions pour pas grand-chose ? Enfin, c'est calme. T'es sûr d'avoir besoin d'un gardien de nuit ?
Viens, je vais te montrer. Tu vois cette porte ? Ça fait un mois qu'elle est coincée et pas moyen de la fermer. Y'a personne pour la réparer. Je me suis déjà fait piquer mon matériel, agressé et personne pour m'aider. Non. Mes voisins ne feront jamais rien d'autre que m'espionner.
Je vois.
Écoute, je vais être honnête avec toi. Je suis super pressé, t'es le seul à avoir répondu à cette annonce. Et je dois absolument retrouver... finir mon projet avant lundi. Alors si t'acceptes de rester jusqu'au bout, moi je te montrerai sur quoi je travaille et... je te ferai même signer un contrat comme assistant. Hein, vois ça comme une période d'essai. Ça te dit? Une dernière question, est-ce que... tu peux commencer ce soir?
Ça peut le faire.
Ok. Écoute, voilà déjà ça, t'auras le reste lundi. Et un talkie-walkie. Hein. Ouais. Et surtout, que personne ne rentre dans le garage, d'accord? Personne ne doit rentrer dans ce garage. Et vraiment, merci beaucoup. Merci, vraiment. Que personne ne rentre dans ce garage. Déjà imaginer une couleur qui n'existe pas. C'est impossible. Ma femme l'a fait.
Ton bras, t'es blessé?
T'inquiète pas pour moi. À demain.
Vous travaillez pour Francis, c'est bien ça?
Oui, jusque lundi.
Vous le connaissez bien?
Non, j'ai commencé hier.
Est-ce qu'il vous a parlé de sa femme, Sonia?
Il l'a mentionné.
D'après ce que j'ai compris, ils sont tous les deux archéologues, ou du moins ils l'étaient avant d'emménager ici. Un soir, je les ai entendus se disputer, violemment à propos d'un voyage trop long, trop loin. Bref, quelques jours plus tard, on n'a plus revu ni entendu Sonia. Un mois maintenant qu'elle a disparu. Et Francis est devenu bizarre, nerveux. Il s'enferme tout le temps dans son garage. Puis maintenant, vous travaillez pour lui. À votre place, je m'en irai avant que ça dégénère.
Sa femme l'a quitté. Donc vous êtes descendu juste pour me dire ça?
Gardez-le, vous en aurez besoin. Entre nous, je suis certaine qu'un jour, on retrouvera son corps mutilé à coups de hache.
Merci pour le café.
Thank you. tu reçois ce message, c'est qu'il est trop tard pour moi. Je l'ai vu, c'était elle, j'en suis sûr. J'ai crié son nom. Si près du but. Je pensais qu'on était seuls là-bas, mais quelque chose m'a mordu. Je suis infecté. Ce sera sûrement mon dernier trajet. Abdel, avant de partir, assure-toi que rien ne sort de cette voiture. Rien ne doit sortir de cette voiture!
Thank you. Subscribe to Dust for new sci-fi every week.